Hi friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Rain. Today we are going to discuss about Article 370 and 35A. We are going to see what is this article and how it is formed and what is the impact of this article to Jammu and Kashmir and what is the status of this article now. Article 370. The Article 370 of the Indian Constitution is a temporary provision which grants special autonomous status to Jammu and Kashmir. And this Article 370 comes under the Part 11 of the Constitution of India, which deals with the temporary, transitional and special provisions. The state of Jammu and Kashmir has been accorded special status under Article 370. That is Article 370 of the Indian Constitution, which will give or grant special autonomous status to Jammu and Kashmir, considering other states. They have a temporary, transitional and special provisions is given to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Actually, the provision for Article 370 was drafted by Sheikh Abdullah, who had been the elected or appointed Prime Minister of Jammu Kashmir. It's not elected, it's appointed Prime Minister of Jammu Kashmir by Maharaja Hari Singh and Jawaharlal Nehru. And they demanded, that is Sheikh Abdullah demanded, that the Article 370 should not be a temporary transition. It should be an ironclad autonomy for the state, which center didn't comply with. And what are all the provisions of this Article 370? Article 370, as a result of this Article 370, Indian citizens from other states cannot purchase land or property in Jammu Kashmir. And under this article, the center has no power to declare financial emergency under this article. And then it can declare emergency in the state only in case of war and external aggression. And the Jammu and Kashmir has been accorded special status under this Article 370, and the constitution which are applicable to other states are not applicable to Jammu and Kashmir, and they have their own constitution. It was a demand or the provision of this Article 370. Moving to Article 35A, and this Article 35A stems from the Article 370, that is, it's a branch of Article 370, having been introduced through a presidential order in 1954. And it empowers the Jammu and Kashmir legislature to define a permanent resident of the state and to provide special rights and privileges to those permanent residents. In the Article 35A is unique and it does not appear in the main body of the constitution, and it empowers the Jammu and Kashmir legislature to define the state's permanent residents and their special rights and privileges. That is, this Article 35A will provide special rights and privileges to those permanent residents, and it also defines the limitations of a non-resident. Now let's see the timeline of events that led to the formation of Article 370 and the status of Article 370 now. And all started in 1947, that is on 26th October, when Hari Singh and the government of India signed the instrument of accession. With this, Kashmir became a part of India. By signing this instrument of accession, Kashmir became a part of India in 26th October 1947. And in 1949, the constitution making constitution of India is not framed at that time. It was in a making process was going on at that time of 1949, and it was not over by that time. And in 17th October 1949, Article 370 incorporated into the Constitution of India. Article 370 was incorporated into the Constitution of India during 17th October 1949. And in 1950, that is when our country become a republic, that is in 1950, 26 January, Constitution of India came into force. That is, the Constitution of India came into action during 26 January 1950. And in 1954, Dr. Rajendra Prasad introduced the Article 35A in the Presidential Order of 1954. That is on 14th May of 1954, Dr. Rajendra Prasad introduced the Article 35A in the Presidential Order 1954. And we cannot see this Article 35A in our Indian Constitution, but we can see that Article 35A in the Constitution of Jammu and Kashmir. And in 1956, Jammu and Kashmir Constitution came into force. That is, their Constitution came into action in 1956. And in 1990, there was an Armed Forces Special Powers Act was imposed in Jammu Kashmir. And in 2015, BJP, that is the Bharatiya Janata Party, had a coalition government. That is, they combined with PDP and formed a new government. And that time, the chief minister was Mehbooba Mufti. Mehbooba Mufti became the chief minister in 2015. And in 2018, BJP breaks up with PDP and the president's rule declared in Jammu Kashmir. In 2018, the president's rule declared in Jammu Kashmir. That is, in our constitution, there is an Article 92. It states that when the constitutional machinery does not run well, the governor can start his rule. That is, the governor rule came into action when the natural constitution machinery is not working well. Thus, in 2018, presidential rule declared in Jammu Kashmir, and at last the governor rule started in June 2018. And in May 2019, the parliamentary elections was there, and in the election memoranda that BJP has included this removal of the Article 370 and 35A, and they finally did that. They revoked the article and splintered Jammu and Kashmir, or bifurcated Jammu and Kashmir into two union territories with the central control over there. And before assigning the instrument of accession, our government of India promised Hari Singh that they will be given a special status if they join the Indian Union. And with this in mind only they signed the instrument of accession. And we promised to give special status to Jammu Kashmir, and to fulfill that, they raised the Article 370, which granted a temporary status or a temporary autonomous power to Jammu Kashmir. By this, all the other laws that are not applicable, that is applicable to other states, will not be applicable to Jammu Kashmir, and there will be special rules to Jammu Kashmir. They have their own constitution. At the time, Constituent Assembly was there, and without the permission of the Constituent Assembly, we cannot revoke the Article 370. Now it's not the Constituent Assembly in action; it is a Legislative Assembly. So we don't have any limitation to revoke this article. Thus, now this article is seized with the Presidential Order of 2019 regarding the Constitution of Jammu and Kashmir. Not Article 370 and 35A is not there. It ceased to exist. And this is all about Article 370 and Article 35A. And before the bifurcation, Jammu Kashmir was a single state. Now, Jammu Kashmir is bifurcated, or it is now changed to two union territories. Thank you for listening this video. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Please subscribe our channel. Share this with your friends.